Well, hi, everybody. I'm Neil Smith, and welcome to my custom 1/20th scale Star Trek The Motion Picture travel pod build. September 2018. Today I started designing a model of the travel pod, first seen in Star Trek The Motion Picture. I had built one before for a client, a small 4-inch version, not extremely detailed, but enough to consider it the prototype for a larger version. This new version would be at 1/20th scale, which would put it at a little under 9 inches long. It would be lit with LEDs and have a fully detailed interior, as well as figures representing Kirk and Scott. Designing the model, I knew I would have to make it, at least somewhat, in kit form if I was going to light it. I needed access to the space between the exterior walls and the interior walls. I also needed to add holes and spaces where I was planning on lighting all the interior controls and screens. I based my design on several blueprints I had found online, but mostly from Mr. Scott's Guide to the Enterprise, one of my most favorite reference sources. The model was designed in Cinema 4D and then printed on my CR10S 3D printer. February 14th, 2019. Many months have passed, and during this time, I have taken on a client build of a Revell Into Darkness Enterprise model. I plan to do a video series on that one as well, so stay tuned for that sometime in the not-too-distant future. Anyway, I need to hit pause on that client build while I wait for the custom electronics to be completed and delivered. And so I thought, it's time to start building the travel pod. I've printed all the parts to the model. Almost every part has undergone some sort of revision. All in all, it took about 3 weeks to print everything.
Okay, so after several weeks of printing, my 1/20th scale travel pod parts are all completed, well, at least printed. We have the various floors and walls, interior and exterior. We got the airlock and the airlock door. Of course, Kirk and Scott. Couches, computer consoles, exterior top, exterior bottom, interior top, and interior bottom. All of these holes like here and here and on the consoles, they will all have translucent translucent film with controls and things printed on them and all that, just to make it all look nice. And the base is sort of designed after the office complex. It's not to scale at all by any means, but I thought it'd make a cool base. Yeah. So there we go.
February 15th, 2019. More work on the travel pod model. Light blocking is complete, and it was time for a dry fit before painting the interior and starting on lighting. February 16th, 2019. Sanding and putty work begins. There will be no 3D printed lines on this one anymore. According to my plan, the interior needs to be completed totally prior to lighting and exterior assembly, so I started that today. March 4th, 2019. I completed the interior with some custom translucent overlays for the control panels and screens, installing the floor and furniture, and putting the Kirk and Scott figures in their place. I'm going to give it all a nice matte coat before moving on to the lights and the exterior assembly. I also need to figure out when the best time to install the glass window will be. March 8th, 2019. I've installed the ceiling and sealed up the interior. I put in thin styrene strips to diffuse the interior lights, and lastly, I've started installing and testing the lights. March 9th, 2019. I glued together the upper and lower exterior parts. I put in and tested almost all of the lighting. I love the way the interior is lit now. And I realized that I'm gonna have to need to fully paint the exterior before final assembly, which I really hate doing. But that's just like me, to design a model that forces me to do something that I don't like. March 11th, 2019. Lots and lots of masking are involved in painting this model. But I'm pretty much done with the overall paint job. A few spots to touch up here and there. Still have to do the black around the lights and the window trim, and all the detail paint and the decals, and then it'll be on to final assembly. March 16th, 2019. I finished the detail paint and started applying the pinstripes. I was using tape from a company whose name I won't mention, but their name rhymes with testers. And it is just garbage. The tape didn't stick worth a darn and was very hard to curve. I'm sure it works great if my surface is flat and straight, but on this model, it was just crap. So I ordered some trusty Lina tape, and that should be here in a few days. So instead of pinstriping, I'm working on the decals. A lot of the decals on the pod are from my unused decal stash, but there are several specific ones that I had made at Cameron's Decals. He does great work, and the decals look fantastic. March 18th, 2019. Now this is how pinstripe tape is supposed to work. It curves where it's supposed to curve, and it laid down cleanly and beautifully. Today I added sheet styrene to the cutout areas for lights. I also started wrangling all the wires to feed through the support rod. Final assembly is getting closer and closer. March 25th, 2019. Today, I have completed my 1/20th scale Star Trek The Motion Picture travel pod model. This build was pretty much a labor of love for me. I really, really love this design and often wondered why it's never been made into a kit before. And while it's far from perfect, I think my model turned out great, and I'm very proud of the build. Here are some of my big learnings from the process. Designing a kit is hard and should be left to the professionals, unless you're a nut job. There is a lot of inaccurate and contradictory information out there about what the travel pod looks like in detail. And although there are some very drastic differences between various sources, on the whole, I'd say my design is fairly accurate. I underestimated the thickness of paint and glue when designing tolerances between parts, and as a result, there were some pretty big seams. These, of course, have all been puttied and repainted and cleaned up, but they are there. On a related note, I need to leave much more space to accommodate lights and wires, etc., between the interior and the exterior parts. I think if I decide to ever make this model again, I will have to redesign the interior to be a little bit smaller to give everything a little bit more breathing room. I overestimated the strength of printed PLA when used for structural parts. The mounting hole at the bottom of the model needed to be way reinforced to securely hold the model in place. I learned that I need to learn a little bit more about amps in regards to lights and LEDs and power and all that. Thanks for the help, Paul. I also learned that I need to trust in my work a little bit more and not always assume that I screwed something up. Well, that's it for this episode. Be sure to subscribe so you can follow along with all of the builds. And if you're interested in any of my recommended modeling tools and supplies, check out my Amazon store in the description below, featuring some of my favorites. Until next time, I'm Neil Smith. Thanks for watching.